is the final experiment with the electric recorder. And this was quite an important one. And this is what I've been working towards for the last, I don't know, 5 or 6 weeks since I first built the electric recorder. You're listening to a MP3 being transferred to an Edison cylinder using an original Edison 2-minute recorder. And on the recorder, rather than putting a horn, I have installed the new Cantophonic driver. And as you can hear, this gives you the ability now to make electric cylinder recordings by simply plugging the recorder into your home stereo and then transferring audio files directly to a cylinder using an original Edison 2-minute recorder and your own cylinder phonograph. And I'm not using any special recorder of any kind. This is a standard Edison 2-minute recorder. This is an NOS. This is an unused 2-minute recorder. And as I said, I've been working towards getting this recorder to work with the electric driver. And I have finally achieved that result. So using the equipment you have, if you simply purchase the driver, you can begin making some really high-quality, loud, clear cylinder recordings on your own cylinder phonograph by simply plugging it into your home stereo. I'm recording this on my iPhone as an MP3, and then through an amplifier directly to the black wax cylinder using an original Edison recorder. So you don't have to purchase anything else. If you have a supply of blanks and the electric recorder, you can start cranking out some really high-quality cylinder recordings. The recorder is going to sell for approximately $159.95. It should work on any Edison cylinder phonograph. If you have any questions or comments, please feel free to drop me an email to victrolaguy@gmail.com.